engineer Dr. Emmanuel Iwuanyanwu on his 75th birthday broke his silence on the Nigerian Civil War. Stay tuned.
After the Civil War, my home was the beginning of all the political activities in the South, in South Nigeria, not just Southeast. All these people, whether they are in NPC, in Labour, in PDP, they were all my boys. In this group that organizes, I have at least 3 senior presidents. I have speakers. I have leaders of political party. Governor is here. Many, they are not here. They are not supporting. Of course, these are all my brothers. And they have always accepted me as their leader. I am 75 years. Before I die, there are some erroneous beliefs fed to the youth of Nigeria, which I think I must correct if I die. One, there is a belief in many places that the coup of 1966 was inspired or instigated by the leaders. It is not true. Yes, the person who led it was an Igbo from Delta State. But he had with him people from other tribes, from Yoruba, from Delta, from other places. So it was a purely military coup. It had nothing to do with Igbos. There was no time Igbo leaders told the military to carry out the coup. If for anything, our great leader, Nnamdi Azikiwe, was sad. He was very sad at the death of Abubakar Tafawa Belewa, at the death of Alhaji Sultan Osokoto, and many other leaders. Abubakar was working very well, was he? A very intelligent, humble young man. He was called Golden Voice in the company, in the United Nations. So I want the younger Nigerians to know that I've been told lies. I want them to know also that that coup failed. Why did it fail? It failed because an Igbo man took up arms, arrested them, as coup plotters and put them in prison. Who is that Igbo man? That was General Aguero. People should know. It's important to know that an Igbo man was the man who made that coup to fail. Ironsi was then commanding the army. If you have supported them, the people have supported. Maybe this story of Nigeria will not be the same as it is today. So Igbos made that coup possible to stop. Well, Ironsi became the head of state. He was killed because he was talking about military government. That is exactly what is happening today. But you know, all of us say we don't want military government. We want a political restructuring. We are very serious, my husband Libor says it, and many Nigerians say it, and I want the National Assembly and other Nigerians to hasten the process of making restructuring this country. Especially the 3 tiers must be independent. Local government, in my own opinion, is the most important tier. Local government is the one with the masses. Politicians, I'm advising you, stop thinking that local government is for learners. Local government is for most experienced politicians. When people retire, as now I've retired, I should be able to run for council. I become a councillor in my place. I should be able to be a chairman of council. When you retire as a permanent secretary, when you retire as a head of state and minister, when that policy is adopted, it means you can carry the experience you have to go to develop your community. Local government should be a very important tier of government that can build its own roads, have water, have light, have agriculture. That is very important. I don't see how somebody can sit here in Abuja and run all the roads in Nigeria. It's not possible. Many years ago, I suggested that power should be given to the states. Let them bring light. We have been working and have failed. We support restructuring. So the truth about this, that's why he died. Now, the other, the third point I want to get to now, the war ended and Nigeria is won today. We are not giving enough credit to the man who made it possible. The man who made it possible is Odonon Dasekiwe. Now, let me start with Ojukwu. Ojukwu was my boss, and I know him very well. Ojukwu never supported secession. When Ojukwu went to Aburi, Ojukwu went to negotiate political instruction of Nigeria. To have people live safely and have access to property. When he never talked about secession in Biafra in Aburi. It was when Aburi collapsed. I am talking as a witness. When Aburi collapsed, he came back. A constituent assembly was established in the east. That assembly declared Biafra not Ojukwu. It is important for me to tell you this before I don't know how long I will live. So Ojukwu never supported secession. Now, it's important for you to know that even when the war ended, Ojukwu went on voluntary exile and he came back, continued working for one Nigeria. So it is wrong for anybody to say Nigerian leaders are supporting, are using Igbos to sort the Igbos. Now, Zeke, the war ended on no victor without. Zeke was instrumental to it. Zeke worked with his friend Topman under the capable leadership of General Gowon. And that is why Nigeria is a peace. Make no mistake about it. If not for that, Biafra at that time was ready to go on the ground. If not as if it happened, that war could have probably lasted the next 20 years. People who have gone on the ground. But Zeke intervened and Nigeria is restored. And Igbos are happy with Nigeria. Igbos have given faith to one Nigeria. That's why if you go to any state in Nigeria, when you look at investment in those states, after the Indigenous people, the next Igbos, I tell anybody to prove me wrong. Now, how else can you say people who are from this area don't belong, don't believe in the country, we believe it? But what we want is fairness. People should be fair to us. People should not abuse us. We want fairness, that's all we want. And then we will support and work for one Nigeria. The day I was born, the world was at war. There was the boom of war, goodness, every bombing all over the world in 1942. In 1945, a very systematic thing happened in the history of mankind. Through man, the President of America thought the expression, sent the first nuclear bomb that went to Japan, Hiroshima and Nagasaki. These two countries were destroyed. The devastation has never been expressed by mankind. That was the first. After the war in 1945, the world realized peace was important. And then they set up, we had a League of Nations. Then they changed to a United Nations. The aim is to make sure we have peace. I was listening to the meeting, the statement of the President of Wahanese and the discussion they have. They talked about nothing else but unity of Nigeria and peace in Nigeria and violence in Nigeria. I have seen the sound of war everywhere in all continents. So I think we are worried. I am worried. We have a very hideous group called ISIS. This ISIS claim they are Islamic, but they are not Islamic. They have killed more Muslims even than Christians. So how can one say they are Islam? I think they are a special group. And I don't know what they want. And I'm sure you know Boko Haram is part of ISIS. I think, frankly speaking, that United Nations should now take a new strategy. Because if he's not taken, these people have a capacity. They have shown they have the capacity to destroy. and they could do more. I think it is time to change their strategy. What we have done so far is to wait and respond. We are not proactive. I think we have to recognize that they are strong. Call them and let us know what they want. Let's have a dialogue. I think dialogue is better. These people, unless we have dialogue with them, they will continue to kill. They will continue to burn. They will continue to pull down aircraft. They don't mind who is there. They even kill themselves. So I think the United Nations should do this. I watched the United Nations at the meeting, and I listened to the President Buhari making his speech. American President said that he was going to destroy North Korea. I don't think he's right. He's not going to visit the destroy North Korea without causing a major crisis that will affect everybody. President of Nigeria, Buhari, said we should negotiate. We should select delegates from countries, United Nations countries, to go and negotiate with North Korea and bring peace. I support that. And I want to congratulate the president for that. That is what I think we should do. Finally, there are two vital prerequisites to make democracy survive. One of them is discipline. One of them is honesty, integrity of the leaders. That is, any people that are corrupt, any standard corruption is being destroyed, can never have proper democracy they can develop. Poverty will engulf the people. Buhari has started the war against corruption. Every right-minded Nigerian must support him. But we must carry this war not just to politicians, because corruption has become endemic in Nigeria and has gone to the fabric of the society. It's there in the universities, in the secondary schools, in the churches, in the mosques, everywhere. So this government must devise a new strategy, not just the fire brigade attack on politicians. But I support Buhari. When Buhari became president, those of you who were there then, you know, Nigeria was chaotic. When you go to the airport, they called the plane for boarding, everybody will rush. He started the war against indiscipline. Today, he said they changed. Nigerians once said are given leadership they would. So war against indiscipline has changed. Us we believe if the war against corruption is properly handled, it will help. God bless all of you. God bless Nigeria.